Hey guys, in this video I'm going to do this statistics and probability problem. It says, suppose that y has PDF the following, and then it gives me a function that's defined from 0 to 1 as ky times 1 minus y and 0 elsewhere. Then it says, find the value of k that makes f of y a probability density function. So we're given a function and we want to determine what constant k will make this function f of y a PDF. So to be defined as a probability density function, there has to be two conditions that are met. So for a function to be a PDF, f of y has to be greater than or equal to 0 for all y. So y defined from negative infinity to infinity has to be positive, so greater than or equal to 0. That's the first condition. And then the second condition is that from negative infinity to infinity, f of y dy has to be equal to 1. So if you integrate over the entire function, that area under the curve of your function has to be equal to 1. So let's go ahead and check these two assumptions for this function and determine which value of k will meet these two conditions. So for the first condition, where the entire function has to be positive over all the range of y, if we plot the original function, it's going to be 0 everywhere except for from 0 to 1. And then from 0 to 1, if we ignore k for a moment and we just plot y times 1 minus y, that's basically going to give us a function that looks something like this. So from 0 to 1, the function is going to be positive. Everywhere else, it's just going to be 0. And basically, you have a half circle that is reaching a peak at 1 quarter. So any positive value of k is just going to have a function that is positive everywhere from 0 to 1. So as long as k, the constant that we're multiplying this part by, is positive, then the function will be positive everywhere from the entire range of y. So from negative infinity to infinity, it will always be positive as long as k is greater than or equal to 0. So our first condition for now is met. Then we actually want to find the exact value of k, and we're going to use the second definition of a PDF to determine the exact value of k. So we're going to integrate from negative infinity to infinity f of y dy, set that equal to 1, and then the only unknown will be the value of k, and that's how we're going to solve for the value of k. So for this function, we only have to integrate from 0 to 1 because everywhere else the function is going to be 0. So if you just integrate over 0, you're still going to get 0. If we do the integral from negative infinity to infinity of f of y dy, that's going to be equal to the integral from 0 to 1 of k times y times 1 minus y dy, and we're going to set that equal to 1. I'm going to distribute the y and the k to the 1 minus y, so that's going to give us the integral from 0 to 1 of ky minus ky squared dy equal to 1. If we integrate this, that's going to give us ky squared over 2 minus ky to the third power divided by 3, and we're going to set that from 0 to 1 is equal to 1. So the integral of ky is ky squared over 2 minus the integral of ky squared is going to be ky cubed over 3. We're going to solve for that from 0 to 1, so if we plug in 1, that's going to give us k over 2 minus k over 3 minus, and then when we plug in 0, that's just going to be 0 minus 0. So we're going to have k over 2 minus k over 3 is equal to 1. K over 2 minus k over 3 is equal to k over 6. Is equal to 1, and then when we solve for k, that's going to give us that k is equal to 6. So 6 is greater than 0, so our first condition is going to be met, where we're going to have f of y is greater than or equal to 0 over the entire existence of y. And our second condition is going to be met when k is exactly equal to 6, because that will give us that the integral over the entire range of the function is equal to 1. So our final answer is k is equal to 6, and we are done with this problem.